Praise the Lord, praise Jesus. Praise the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I'm from the Rock Intercessor Ministries. I'm here today to preach to you the word of Jesus Christ. Hoping that some of you give your life to God today, amen. Now today's message is fitness. The message is what? Fitness. So today is a fitness one-on-one with the word of God, my dear friend. Amen. So listen to this, because your health is the most valuable possession that you have today than any other prized material possession. You see? Because God wants you, my dear friend, to do what? To have a good health and to have what? Good fitness. You see? The Bible said that He wishes for every one of us to do what? To prosper. Even as our soul prospers. So the Bible says that Bible have a lot of words concerning our bodies. The Bible said that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. You hear that? We are fearfully and wonderfully made in the image of Jesus Christ. And that our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, which we are God doers. In 1 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 19, or don't you know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, within which you, where you have God from? You are not on your own, for you are bought with a price. Now watch this. He says, so glorify God in your body. And that is your fitness, my dear friend. You see, God has paid a greater price for you and for me than any price material possession. You see, you are not on your own. Therefore, God have joined you and commanded you to do what? To glorify God in your body as well as in your spirit. Now, the psalmist said this concerning his body, that he was fearfully and wonderfully made. Psalm 139 verse 14. The psalmist said that I praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. You, my dear friend, you ought to do what? To say the same thing. You see, your body is carefully crafted. Your body is wonderfully tuned. It's a tuned machine. Look at your body, your heart, your hands, your leg, your eyes, your nose. All these things are what? It's a machine. And thank God, because when God created this body, God gave us a maintenance manual, which is what? His word, which is the Bible. Your Bible, my dear friend. So now you remember that you have been purchased with the precious blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says your body does not belong to you anymore. So your body belongs to God. And then the Bible says, in which God dwells, which is His temple. Do you know that? And then that temple has to be maintained. And the Bible teaches us that our body belongs to God. And therefore, we have to do what? Dedicate our body to Him. Some people today will think only about the spiritual things, only about their soul. But I want to tell you today, never forget about your body. Because why? You have to look after care of your body. Because the Bible says, your body is the temple of God. Many people today don't think that way, because perhaps they see their body as a sinful, as evil. But my dear friend, listen to what Apostle Paul says in the book of Romans chapter 12 verse 1 to 2. Apostle Paul says, I appeal to you, brothers, to be merciful of God, to present your body as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God. Is your body presentable to God? Upton Park. Is your body holy? Is your body acceptable to God? Because, my dear friend, God is interested in your total person, your total body. God is interested in your soul. God is interested in your spirit. But God also was interested in your body. Listen to what the Bible says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 23. Paul says, may the God of peace Himself sanctify you completely, and may your whole spirit, body, and soul be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So He says, your body, your soul, and your spirit. I'll put it the way Paul put it together. He said, spirit, body, and soul. So spirit is within your spirit. You have this spiritual life. And to know the world above. Your soul, within your soul, you have this physical life that knows the world around you. Your body, With your body, you have a physical life that relates to what, to the world beneath you. You see? So when your spirit is right, you are happy. When your soul is right, you are satisfied. When your body is right, you are healthy. You see? So now you have what? A perfect two person. All to the world to be holy, happy, and healthy. Most people today in UK, they are unholy, they are unhappy, and they are unhealthy. I mean, they turn out their body out of stock, out of fellowship. You see? So no wonder the Bible says you have to do what? Kept your body blameless. And listen to it again. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 23. I pray God that your whole spirit and soul and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. You see, God wants you, my dear friend, to do what? To be blameless. That we ought to do what? To do anything. We don't do anything, we do what? Terminate our body, our soul, and our spirit. God wants your body, your soul, and your spirit to be what? Blameworthy. You see? So what he's trying to say here is this, this word, one-on-one check. Today, you are doing, having a body check today with the word of God. And my message for you today is fitness. You see? So at the moment that we are living in this world, our body will never be perfect health until we go to heaven. Now, there's a number of reasons why we have a physical illness. I'm going to give you four reasons why you have to know this. And I want you to listen to them, my dear friend. Because first of all, we have to understand, amen, there's a cure if you accept Jesus Christ, but there's a cause that is being placed upon this creation. We are living in a world which is a fallen world. So that means that the world has been cursed with sin upon it. If you look into the book of Genesis, as soon as Genesis chapter 3 opened there, what do you see there? It said before. And that's where the whole downfall started, my dear friend. Now, in the book of Romans chapter 5 verse 12, Paul says, therefore, let, just as a sin came into the world through one man, and death also through sin, and so death spread to all men because all have sinned. So in other sense, every one of us today, all over the world, we have what? Interminable what? Sickness. We are ill. Do you know what our sickness is? The Bible diagnoses our sickness. It says sin. Every one of us walking around, myself included, every one of us, we are sick with sin. And I tell you today, the latest statistic upon death says what? One out of one person dies. Do you know that? We all have what? Terminal illness. And that terminal illness, the Bible says it is a sin. Because Adam have this sin, and every one of us have sin. And then we all fall short of the glory of God. So we might as well admit it to say today that the people, when they die, you can't say they die natural death. That's nothing like natural death, my dear friend. All death is what is unnatural. All death is what due to what? The result of sin. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. Alright, my dear friend. And that's one of the reasons we are being sick. And then sometimes when we are sick, it's because why we also do what? Violated the God's moral law. Every kick has a kickback. Every sin fanistates. And then again, he also do what? Assassinate. Many people today, they die because why? They sin in their life. For example, what about the church in Corinth when Apostle Paul writing to them? They were living a blameless way, even with the Lord's Supper, and they were kind of like misusing the Lord's Supper. The Bible said this in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 29. For anyone who eats and drinks without discerning the body eats and drinks judgment on himself. Do you hear that? And verse 30 said, that is why many of you are weak and ill, and some have died. And then he says that if we judge ourselves truly, we will not be judged. No wonder the Bible says, examine yourself to see if you are in faith. Amen. So my message for you today is fitness. You see, is your body wholly acceptable to God? Which is what your special worship, by the way. You see, sickness sometimes will come Because why? This is the judgment of God. And sometimes when we are sick, it's because we are being afflicted by the Satan. Remember Job, when Job was sick, and the Lord said to Satan in the book of Job, chapter 2, verse 6, and the Lord said to Satan, behold, he is your hand. Only spare his life. What about Apostle Paul? When he talked about the thorn that is in his flesh, that was what the result of what? Satan. So my dear friends, sometimes we are under satanic attack, and that's one of the reasons why we are sick. And sometimes that's why we are sick, because why? It's a discipline of God. Remember the Bible says God heals and God also wounds. Sometimes sickness comes in your life, you are not fit enough. It's only when you're lying down, that's when you want to see God. So you, my dear friend, got to do what to think this message. My message for you today is very loud and clear, is fitness. So sometimes we are under this attack, and because of what? The result of sin. So we all know what David said in the book of Psalm 119, verse 71. It is good for me that I was afflicted, that I may learn the status. So here is a man that was afflicted. It takes the grace of God and the wisdom of God and the faith to know that when you have been afflicted, God wants to draw you back to Him. So sometimes, when we fall flat on our back, and when we look up, what do we think? We can move. Is that too clearly through the clear of what as crying eyes and the tears are being washed away by the power of the tears that we can see clearly, so that we can see that we need God. Sometimes, however, our sickness is due to what? The violation of God's natural law. What I mean here is this. How do you respond to the God's natural law? Do you respond to it well? For example, a lot of people today, they are poisoning their body with nicotine. Or you say, can I smoke and go to heaven? Truly, the true matter is this, my dear friend. You might get there quicker than later. You see? Because smoking, it's like you feeling already, you are seeing a signal that you already perceiving the hell, my dear friend. Why do you want to let fire burn into the temple that God says you have to kept holy? You see? So today, if you violate God's natural law, you will do what? You will get the punishment. You see, you put it in this way. It's like the law of the gravity. When you jump from that building, it's possibly that you're going to fall and die. God can never change it. That's not what God can do. God can help you out, my dear friend, when you violate God's natural law. Upton Park, don't you know that God made nicotine for you to do what? To kill the boss and not for the people. You can take that into your body. You see, God cannot just give you a pass to go to heaven when you violate His natural law. Think with me, my dear friend. That's why you ought to do what? To put the weed away, put the smoking away, put the drugs away, put the drinks away, anything that will do what contaminate your body. Because the Bible says, you, my dear friend, your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, which you are God doers. So God wants to heal us. But then again, we cannot continue living the same way we used to live. And this is very important, my dear friend. You ought to do what? To be fit. Amen. You cannot neglect God's natural law. You see? Because God has laid down His rule in the book, which is called the Bible. And it teaches us that our mind and our soul have to do what? To be ruled by our body. Just as our spirit rules our soul, your body is really is your servant. And if you abuse your servant, which is your body, if you abuse your body, which is your servant, and then that the whole body, what do you think will rise up? It will smack you, my dear friend. That's why it's unforgivable. That's why you have sickness. You see, talking about fitness, you have to exercise, my dear friend. That also go to me, by the way. Hallelujah. We have to do what? Keep fit. Amen. Then again, your body is the most valuable asset that you have, even more than money. You see, because what you've done so far today, we value money than our health. You see, when we value money than our health, you put it in this way, you spend half of your lifetime, you are chasing the paper, you're chasing money. And when you get that money, when you are old, you know what happens? You start using the money back again to treat yourself. It's like you having a good time, and then again, your good time turned to bad time. So your health is very, very important, my dear friend. My message for you today is fitness. And many people today are living that way. They accumulate all this wealth and then wasted the wealth to do what? Treat themselves. It's like a man burning the end of two candles. It's like a dog chasing after his own tail. So today I want you to understand, every kick has a kickback, my dear friend. You have to do what? To look into your health. Because that your body doesn't belong to you. The Bible says I've been purchased, and that body belongs to God. So today, many of us today try to get back to health after we have wasted all this time with our body, and we have been abusing with drugs, we are busy with smoking, we are busy with you name it, gluttony, overeating, you just name it, my dear friend. And then again, it takes time for us to do what? To get it back. It depends on how old you are, my dear friend. Most Christians these days they are the real heavyweight, isn't it? You know? And there's a health risk with it as well. Spiritually, physically, emotionally, you name it. So today, my dear friend, we ought to do what? To value God. The funny thing here is this, my dear friend. We value money than our health. And the money is the most envied thing today in society. But then again, the health is the least envy. But then again, the health is what is the least envy. But then again, the health is something that you have to do what? To enjoy later on. And until when we lose it, that's when we realize our health is very important. So today, my dear friends, God cares about your health. Jesus died for you. He's telling you today to keep your body as a holy. Do you know about sex? Only the people who have the normal sex, who enjoy sex, are the married people. Any sex outside marriage is sin. There's no enjoyment in it. You only harm your body. The Bible says sin against your own body and against God at the same time.
Yeah, right.
So the sex is only privilege to the married people. Right. God bless you, man. Amen?
Amen.
And that's the message that you want to hear today. Fitness. How can you be fit? How can a young man be fit? It's not only going to the gym, but keeping your way pure, my dear friends. Amen? So today, we need to do what? To value our health. Because if you don't value it, when we lose it, it's going to be too late, you see? So a healthy man loses his health, and then again, he gives all his health back. He wants to gain it back. Sometimes it might be too late. You see? So this matter I'm talking to you today about fitness, a lot of us today are sick today. I mean, we are sick with our sin. Many of us today, we've been sacrificing our body in the altar of drunkenness, overeating, bad habit, and then again, gluttony, and then again, we are heavy. We become heavy duties. So the Bible says, no wonder the Bible says, their God is their belly. Jesus Christ said, man shall not eat by bread alone, but every word that proceeds from the mouth of God, my dear friend. Their God is their belly. Because why? They fascinate themselves in the evil things. And because you fascinate yourself in the evil things, then again, that fascination will turn to assassination. You see? That's why the Bible said their God is their belly, and therefore their glory is in their shame. Do you know why? Because they send their minds on the earthly things. So how fit are you today? Upton Park, how fit are you? He said, because just what it says in the book of Matthew chapter 9 verse 12, those who are well do not need a physician, but those who are sick. And he says, I desire mercy. So God wants to show you mercy and not sacrifice. Don't sacrifice yourself on the things that is unworthy, my dear friend. Because he said, I have come not for the righteous but the sinners. So today, I'm going to give you four principles. Amen? Four principles that will keep you healthy. One of them is discipline. Second of them is what? Devotion. Third of them is what? Deposition. The fourth of them is what? Decision. We have to make decision in our lives. Amen? So the first one is discipline. Upton Park. Fitness is what? It's a matter of what? Discipline. And every Christian knows how to do what? Discipline is also what? Equal to what? Disciples. You see? So the word discipline, if you link it together, discipline and disciple, they're the same thing. You see? We cannot be disciples of God, and then we are not disciplined. And if we are not disciplined, then we are not disciples. Because Apostle Paul says, in the 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 24, he said, don't you know that we are running a race? That all runners, they run, but not only to do what, to receive the prize, so they run that they may obtain it. And every actress, they exercise self-control in all things. Self-control is one of the fruit of the spirit. You ought to do what to have. You see, because when you have self-control, under the stress, you can control it. Amen? And then I said, they do it to do what, to receive perishable wealth. But not even imperishable. So I do not run aimlessly. I do not boss as one boss in the air. This is a man of God telling you that he's doing all this in one. He's not doing it for just sake. He's not bossing the air. Have you ever seen anyone bossing the air? You're wasting your time. He says, but I discipline my body and to keep it under control, at least after preaching to others, that I myself should not be disqualified. So you put it in this way. Look at the actress. I use Usain Bolt as an example. He win all this accolade, he win all this gold, but he can't take this gold to heaven. Everything that he win, we stays here, my dear friend. So the Bible says, my message for you today about fitness, you train yourself, but then again, you need to think about what? The spiritual things as well, my dear friend. You see? So for example, we need to do what? To discipline ourselves in this matter of fitness. And we Christians, we have a lot of heavyweight these days. Apostle Paul says in book of Philippians chapter 4 verse 12, Apostle Paul says that I know that is to be in need, I also know to have in plenty. I have learned the secret of being in content in any and every situation, whether I well fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. So here is a man says that he knows if you don't have to eat, he can bear it. Talk about fasting, unwarranted fasting. If you don't have to eat, he can bear it. If you have, you don't have, it doesn't matter. He said he can do all things through Christ Jesus Christ, who strengthens him. Amen. So today, my dear friend, my message for you is fitness. You can do all things through Christ Jesus Christ, who strengthens you. And then again, it goes on to say in 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7, have nothing to do with reverent and silly mate. So he's telling you today, my dear friend, talk is cheap. Now listen to this. He said, let us train yourself for godliness. So we ought to do what? To train ourselves for godliness. Talking about fitness, the Bible says, train yourself for godliness. So let us train yourself for godliness. For why your whole bodily training is for some value. So the Bible says that your fitness, that you go to gym, to pump the iron, to chisel out, and to do all these things, the Bible says it's for some value. Amen. You ought to do what? There's some benefit in exercise, by the way. Physical exercise, there's some profit in it. What he's saying here is this, that godliness is more profitable. You see, it's not telling you that don't exercise, but then exercise. But it's telling you what is the more profitable in it is what? Godliness. It's more value in every way. Why? Because it's all the promises for the present, for this present life, and also for the life to come. So today, that means you can gain life, godly life, you can gain it in this life, and also what, you can gain it in life to come. I mean, we Christians know, we never lose. We have already won. Jesus is Lord. You see, so as much as you go to the gym to pump all these muscles, you ought to do what? To exercise your faith and to share your faith. I mean, that's the reason why I'm here, by the way, my dear friends. To do what? To exercise my faith and to share my faith. You see, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't share the faith, the Bible says that what you have will also be taken away from you. That's a big one in there. You see, this idea we ought to do what? To keep the faith. No, share the faith. I come here today to share the faith to you. Am I sharing faith today for you, my dear friend, is what? Fitness. And that fitness is to do what? To keep your body blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So then again, I want you to understand also in this message about fitness, what about worried? Are you worried today? You said that I'm not fit. The Bible says that cast all your anxiety to him, that Jesus Christ, because he cares for you. What about doubt? Do you have doubt that he can't do it? Jesus Christ said in the book of Mark, chapter 11, verse 22, he said, have faith in God. What about distrust? You don't trust God? My dear friend, the Bible said that I can do all things through Christ Jesus Christ who strengthens me. Hallelujah. What about fear? Are you afraid? The 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7 says, for God has given us not the spirit of fear, but of love, power, self-control, and sound mind, my dear friend. What about despair? Why should it be in despair? Just what I say in the book of John 16 verse 33. I have said these things to you, that in me that you may have peace. And in this world, watch this, you will have tribulation. But he said, keep, take heart, for I have overcome the world. So when Jesus Christ overcome the world, you, my dear friend, also overcome the world. Hallelujah. So this is fitness message. And you, my dear friend, are you young? Serve God. Are you old? Serve God. Remember, God bless you, brother. I mean, just loves you. Remember Peter? God bless you. Remember Peter, when Jesus Christ was saying to him, do you love me? 3 times he asked Peter, do you love me? Peter cannot get upset because he knew he loved God, but it wasn't what he meant to do. Because he went out fishing, he was doing the wrong business. And just Christ said, feed the sheep. So up the park, I come here to feed the sheep. But I tell you today, my dear friend, if you're not feeding the sheep, when you grow, you're gonna be so bad, it's gonna be so bad for you because you can't do it. You won't have the zeal. There's some places you don't want to go, people will take you there. Amen. So today, if you are young and you have faith, you should be as old as your doubt. Amen. Young as your self-worth, confident, as old as your fear, as young as your hope, as old as your despair. So why do you have stress? Why are you stressed out? You see, stress is that gap between our trust and our demand that we put upon ourselves based on our feelings and emotions. Amen. I want you today to put your faith in Jesus Christ. You see, now this brings me to a deep position. That is the reason the Bible says in the book of Isaiah 40 verse 28 verse 31. Haven't you known? Haven't you heard that the Lord is everlasting God, the creator of all the ends and ends of the earth? He does not faint. So that means the Bible tells you today that God does not pass out or grow weary. So that means God never gets tired. His understanding is unsearchable. So that means God is never paralyzed. He can never figure God out. You know the one thing I want you to know today, my dear friend? God don't need anybody to explain anything to him. God knows it all. And verse 29, he says, he has given us power. He has given power to the faint. And to him who has not might, he will increase his strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall fail as exalted. But he who wait on the Lord, he shall renew his strength. So the word here, renewing the strength here, this means, which only means what? God here is what? In changing, he's taking away your strength and giving you his strength. Amen. And then again, it says, when the weakness comes, God will give you strength. And then they say, she mount up their wings like an eagle, and they shall run and they will not be weary, and they shall walk and they will not faint. Hallelujah. So today, Upton Park, the message is for fitness. Now here comes the division. You see, because you, my dear friend, you need Jesus Christ in your life. Do you want to be fit? You need Jesus Christ in your life. Amen. You need a place where you can worship God. You see, it takes discipline. It takes disposition. He also the water devotion in this matter of fitness that I'm preaching to you today. It is matter of what? Devotion. You see, you ought to do what? To love God. And when you love God, what do you do? You serve God with all your heart. The Bible says that those who serve God will serve God what? In truth and in spirit. Amen. Now the Bible says that once you're serving God today, my dear friend, you will be healthy. Do you know why? Because the book of Romans chapter 8 verse 28 says, all things work together for good for them that love God. So my friend, do you love God? You see, because if you love God, the Bible says you'll be healthy. So faith give us what? Good health. Pure religion also do what? Give us good health. Devotion of time also do what? Going to church, praising God, worshiping God, loving God. All this will make you to do what? To be fit. It is amazing how faith give us what? Give us good health, and also what? Give us fitness that is in the Lord. Hallelujah. So another one is decision. And this is the final message in this fitness. To make a decision. People people today cannot make decision today. Do you know why it baffles me? They make a decision where they go and eat. They make a decision who they give their wife, their children to marry. They make a decision where they go to work. But when it comes to God, people don't want to make a decision to serve God. You know why that baffles me? The devil is a liar, my dear friend. You see? So it's very important that today, my dear friend, that you make a decision. You see, you make a decision which direction that you may go. So there's a decision to be made today, my dear friend, to give your life to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So nobody can make that decision for you. Your mother can make it for you. Your father can make it for you. I can make it for you. You see, you have to take what personal responsibility, make a decision, and stand on it. Listen to what Joshua said in Joshua chapter 24, verse 15. Now, here Joshua talking to the children of Israel, by the way, and he says this. And if it is evil in your eyes to serve the Lord, choose this day who you will serve, whether gods of your fathers serve in the region beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites, in whose land you dwell. But as for me, watch this, he said, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. But I can still tell you today, my dear friend, as for me and my household, we will serve the living God. Amen. I made that decision. I got my mind made up, my dear friend. You have to make a decision today whether I want to serve God or not. The Bible said today is not salvation, not tomorrow. Do you know why? Friend, tomorrow may never come. You see? So it is a matter of decision. It's your fitness right now. You have to stand up. Stand up for your right, isn't it? So stand up today and make a decision to start the living God. You see? He said that you have to do what? Choose. You remember? How do you serve the Lord? Remember Apostle Paul's prayed in the 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 23. I pray to you that your whole spirit, I pray to God that your whole spirit and your soul and your body will be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So it deals with what? It deals with what? Body discipline. It deals with what? Soul disposition. It deals with what? Spirit devotion. But you have to do what? To make a choice. Or you say, but like Kingsley, I can make a choice. I say, yes, you can make a choice. We make choices in this life. You wake up in the morning, you choose the clothes, you dress. That's a choice right there. You cross the road, make sure car don't hit you. You look like you look left. That's a choice they're making. So we make choices in every single day. So no more excuses, my dear friend. You have to do what? Make a choice. Because Joshua said, as for me and my household, we will serve the living God. Do you know why? Because they have other gods there. Remember Israelites came out from Egypt. They used to call different kind of gods before God. And then again, they're living in this land of the Amorites, which the land they dwell. Those people also have their God. God bless you, my brother Ali. God bless you. How is your food better? Jesus is Lord. Amen. So today, my dear friend, yeah, Joshua is saying that if you look around, there's other gods. If you look around, there's other false religion. If you look around, there's other philosophers. Then again, look. He said, look at the Jehovah God. I mean, what God is trying to say here is this, my dear friend. He said that if you bring other gods, he will beat them all, he will beat all of them. He said, well, he will beat all of them. If you bring other false religion, if you bring all these false philosophies, if you bring all these people that you are looking around, living around them, he's telling you that his God is greater than them. You see? So we need to do what? Yeah, see what they believe. See how they're serving that God, serving that false prophet. And look, see if you are serving a living God or you want to go in a different path. You have a choice to make today, my dear friend. And then again, he said, listen, are you going to choose today? My dear friend, are you going to choose? Because you are going to do what? To choose to serve. I'm talking about making a choice right now. You are free to choose. You are free to make a choice, but you are not free to choose the consequences that are coming your way, my dear friend. You see, not to choose, it's already make a choice. You see, because as you are free to choose, you are free not to choose the consequences that are coming to your way. This is very important. You see, you have a freedom to choose whether I want to serve God or not. But if you are not serving God, you have already make a choice. So if you are not serving Jesus Christ, That means you have already made a choice. So that means you are serving devil. So if you are not serving God, you are serving devil. And because you are serving devil, the Bible said that you cannot choose the consequences of your action. You see? So your free choice is very important. But then again, you need to make a right choice. Amen? Because the consequences of your choice, you cannot choose it anymore. You see, once you have made a choice, okay? So you choose, but then again, you cannot choose the consequences. Hallelujah. And that's why today, you, my dear friend, you need to change your lifestyle and give your heart to Jesus Christ. Okay? So then again, I want you to look into inside your life. See what you are doing, what you are eating, what you are drinking, what you are smoking. All these things that you are doing, if it's not giving God the glory, the Bible says your glory is in your belly. That's your God there. And it's in your shame. So come back to Jesus Christ today. Listen, my dear friend, you have to make a choice now. You know why? Because Jesus Christ is coming soon. And the Bible said, when you made that choice, give your heart to Him. The Apostle Paul had prayed. He said that He prayed for me and for you, our whole body, our spirit, our soul will be kept blameless on the day of the Lord coming, Jesus Christ. Do you know why? He said, because He who calls you is faithful, and He will surely do it. Amen. Blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen and amen and amen. Come back today and give your heart to Jesus Christ, my dear friend. Amen. Blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus is Lord.